Hey guys, I'm Dr. Mike Hansen, and welcome to another video. Recently, the Delta variant of COVID-19, aka B16172, has been spreading across the globe. Is it more contagious? Will the vaccines work against it? Is it a deadlier disease with worse symptoms? Now, I'm going to get to these questions in a little bit. But first, a quick update on COVID. The U.S. has over 33 million confirmed cases and more than 601,000 deaths. Worldwide, that's about 180 million cases and close to 4 million deaths. According to the CDC, almost 150 million Americans have been fully vaccinated. That's about 45% of the population. The Delta variant first emerged in India, and then it made its way to England to become the dominant strain there. Is the Delta variant more pathogenic, meaning is it more likely to cause worse disease? Yes. In a study done in Scotland, which was published in The Lancet, researchers showed that the risk of being hospitalized with the Delta variant is double that of the Alpha variant. Recently, the Delta variant has made its way to the U.S., where it already constitutes 10% of COVID cases. However, that figure is doubling every 2 weeks, and it's only a matter of time before it becomes a dominant strain. Right now, in the Midwest, it makes up about 25% of cases in Colorado, Montana, North and South Dakota, Utah, and Wyoming. Now, in a study done in the UK from May 20th to June 7th, the researchers led by Stephen Riley, they looked at their data, which suggested that the Delta variant is about 60% more transmissible than the Alpha, which was the variant that was first identified in the UK, which is more contagious than the original strain that was originally emerging from Wuhan. The research team showed that with the Delta variant, there was a doubling time of 11 days and an estimated R, or reproductive number, of 1.44. And those younger than age 50 were 2.5 times more likely to be infected compared to older people. Another study looked at whether vaccines, monoclonal antibodies, or antibodies derived from COVID-19 survivors could neutralize the Delta variants. Here are some of the takeaways from that study. For one, the data showed that the Delta's variant affinity for the ACE2 receptor was slightly better compared with the original Wuhan strain. One of the Delta's mutations is in its receptor binding domain, and that's what allows for this. This virus uses its spike protein to bind to the ACE2 receptor in the body. It's the key in the lock analogy. The virus then fuses with the cell membrane. This process relies on cleavage, meaning enzymes on the cell membranes that cut that spike protein at two different sites, which triggers the cell to then engulf this virus. It's the turning of the deadbolt, if you will. Well, guess what the Delta variant is also better at doing? There's a second Delta mutation at one of the cleavage sites. Better cleavage, better reproduction. Another takeaway from the study is that the authors concluded that neutralization of both viruses is reduced when compared with the original Wuhan strain, but there's no evidence of widespread antibody escape. They said the data did suggest that those previously infected with COVID may be more susceptible to reinfection by the new Delta variant. Also, it looks like monoclonal antibody treatments are ineffective at treating the Delta variant. The big concern is vaccine escape, meaning that the current vaccines will become far less effective as the virus evolves. So far, it hasn't happened, but eventually we'll need new vaccines for the variants, likely a yearly thing. The good news is that these vaccines are still protective against the Delta variant. According to research released by Public Health England, for the Pfizer vaccine, after both doses, it was 88% effective in preventing symptomatic disease and 96% effective at preventing hospitalization. For the Oxford-AstraZeneca vaccine, if they had both shots, it was 92% effective at preventing hospitalization. If you only get one shot of either one of these vaccines, the effectiveness is pretty low. It's around 30 to 40%. So more studies will soon be available when it comes to the Moderna and the Johnson & Johnson vaccines. There's also talk about this Delta variant having new symptoms and possibly more severe symptoms. So Tim Spector, who is a professor of genetic epidemiology at King's College in London, he runs the Zoe COVID symptom study. This is an ongoing UK-based study where people can enter their symptoms on an app, which then gets analyzed by the researchers. From this study, he noted that COVID is now acting differently. It's more like a bad cold, especially in the younger population. the number one symptom being headache, and then other symptoms including sore throat, runny nose, and fever. So that's going to be all for this one. Thank you for watching. And if you did like this video, don't forget that like button. And if you haven't done so already, hit that subscribe and bell notification. See ya.